So I just talked about the organization of concepts and the relationship of concepts with each other. We already come across this when we were talking about background knowledge in the previous lesson on incremental concept learning. So we had a brick and a wedge. They were both subclasses of a block. In general, the organization of concepts can be much more complex. So here is a set of concepts that you're probably all familiar with. We have different kind of animals, vertebrates, invertebrates. Vertebrates themselves can be of different kinds, reptile, birds, mammals, and so on. And here are birds, which can be of different kinds, eagles, bluebirds, and penguins, like we saw in the previous slide. In general, the organization of these concepts can be a little bit more complicated. So this is a conceptual hierarchy that I expect all of you are familiar with. The animals of various kinds, vertebrates and invertebrates, for example. And vertebrates themselves can be of different kinds, reptiles, birds, mammals, and birds can be of different kinds, for example, eagles, bluebirds, and penguins. So these are classes, and these are subclasses and superclasses. Now, the advantage of this kind of conceptual organization is that I can start going in a top-down way, establishing and refining each category. So you see an animal and you're trying to decide whether that animal is a bluebird or an eagle or a penguin. And you may start initially by saying, well, is it a vertebrate? Then is it a bird? And if it is a bird, then is it an eagle, a bluebird, or penguin? When you and I do processing of this kind, it might happen so fast that we might not be aware of it. But when we're trying to build an AI agent, we have to make that processing very, very explicit. Even among humans, imagine, for example, what happens when a scientist discovers a new kind of species. Then the scientist may begin from the top and say, well, is it a vertebrate? Where exactly should industry, should I put this species? Is it a bird? Is it closer to eagle? Should I put it closer to a bluebird? And so on. So classification of this kind often has a top-down, establish, refine character to it.
So one of the benefits of this establish and refine approach is it helps us figure out which variables we need to actually key in on and focus on. So for example, we saw earlier that eagles are large, but bluebirds are small. So birds can come in different sizes. So if we're trying to establish whether something's a bird, a reptile, or a mammal, we know that mammals also come in different sizes, like tiny mice or large elephants. So size doesn't really impact our decision whether it's a reptile, bird, or mammal. But once we've established that it's a bird and we're trying to decide between eagle and bluebird, for example, we know that size actually can be something that helps us differentiate between these two. So now we'll pay attention to size as a variable that matters.
So note that there are several things going on here. On one side, there is knowledge of these different classes, but there's also organization of these different classes in a hierarchy of a particular kind. This organization is very powerful. In some ways, if knowledge is power, so is organization. Organization too is power. This organization provides power because this organization tells you what the control of processing should be. Establish one node, refine it. Establish that node, refine it.